Hey there, how's it going? What's up, everybody? Irish Orangutan is back to pass along what you need to know to get better at Madden and grow your Mutt team. Enjoy the show. This Sunday, we have another top 10. Today, we are going to be focused on some of the people that can give you that little bit extra on your team, the fullbacks and tight ends. These players are able to do something that separate themselves and can go up and catch an extra pass or block a little bit better than someone else. So we are digging in. In the past, we have looked at the defense a little bit more closely with the 3-4 and 4-3 up front. So make sure you go and check those out. But getting things kicked off for the fullbacks and tight ends at number 10, we have Kellen Winslow. He is great and going up and catching that high ball in the end zone. You can run curls, run him on a post, and he'll be able to go up and get that. Make sure you are using that left bumper and getting that up to him, being 6'5" and having 96 spectacular catch. That is the thing that he stands out with, but he also has nice speed and is capable at run blocking as well, so he can fit into most offenses and you don't have to just scheme him off the field the rest of the game. Coming in at number 9, we have one of my personal favorites of the Ultimate Legends that came out this year, Mike Alstott. It was fun to watch him growing up running people over. Sadly, that kind of portion of his game has not perfectly carried over to Madden and Mutt, but he does hit a lot of the thresholds that you need, and he's able to catch the ball very well out of the backfield. Almost too well compared to some of the halfbacks that are in the game. But he does hit the threshold for being able to get lead the way also, and is a good fit for a lot of different players that want to run different things. And with his size, he's also capable at running some of those whams and getting some people out of the way. I would absolutely recommend Alstott for any team. And if you run a little bit more of a passing scheme, he can be a good fit at going out of the backfield and catching the ball, but also never missing a block. So he is perfect for just about any scheme, but I would definitely scheme him up a little bit more if you're going to be passing the ball. Coming in at number 8, we have Dallas Clark. He is the best West Coast tight end in my mind. He is great at just going out and running the perfect route. If you just need someone that is going to be able to do that and then throw a spin move and get a few extra yards, he's going to be perfect for your scheme. I really like him in certain situations like that. I would have liked to test him out a little bit more throughout the year, but the Redskins have had a couple of good tight ends, but I've seen a lot of upper echelon teams go out and play with him and do very well. I would definitely recommend this Dallas Clark, especially if you are doing some H-back things and just getting him in the backfield also. Coming in at number 7, we have Vernon Davis. He is the best tight end on my team. He has tremendous speed. On my team, we can get that up to a 99. We have him powered up plus one. And then we have Coach Men. And then we have Sprinter. And then the 3-4 that Redskins chem. So we're able to get him up to that 99. Just had to do the math in my head on that to make sure I wasn't going to lie to you. But he is someone that can run every clear out route. He is a lot better if you can get him in space. That catching traffic is high, but catching not high point passes are dropped more frequently than I think they should, and high point passes are caught more frequently than I think they should. So that is a little bit of a knock on him, but he's able to just absolutely run away from people once he does get the ball. I would not have him as your number one run blocker as his run blocking is a little bit low, but if you split him out at wide receiver, he has that upper echelon speed. He can run the routes like a wide receiver, and he has better run blocking than any wide receiver in the game. So if you're able to scheme with him, he can probably be the best tight end on your team, but it's just something that you have to scheme up a little bit. Coming in at number six, we have Lorenzo Neal. He is a tremendous talent at doing his specific thing, and that thing is impact blocking and lead blocking better than absolutely everyone in the game. He is going to be due for an upgrade here shortly for an ultimate legend, and he'll be able to actually run the ball with a little bit of enthusiasm as well. To be honest, at this point, and if you're not running some eye or goal line sets where you have him lead blocking, he probably doesn't fit into your offense. But if he does, this is the player that you absolutely need to have in your team. Hopefully they have Daryl Green and Lorenzo Neal come out as Ultimate Legends next weekend. That would be perfect for my team. We'd be able to fill in a couple gaps and have some of the best players fill in those gaps possible. So go out and get Lorenzo Neal if you run that I formation or strong or weak as well. Coming in at number five, we have Shannon Sharp. Again, he is due an Ultimate Legend sometime soon when they get those other players added in for those Hall of Fame players. But if you have his captain as well, he can fit in at number five right now and do a darn good job with the legend that they do have out for him. He's a tremendous run blocker. Being 6'2", he's not going to be perfect at high pointing, but he can definitely get the job done if he is in space. But he is someone that can fit in every offense, run his routes to perfection, and get yards after the catch. So he fits into every scheme. He's tremendous at everything that he does. So he is someone that can fit into your team right now if you have him as a captain. If you are starting to fill up at other positions like wide receiver, middle linebacker, or defensive end, where those other captains are, this is someone that can come in. And if you don't want him to start, he can be your second or third tight end and come in and block for you in goal line or heavier sets. So if you don't want him as your starter, he's perfect at second or third tight end also. Coming in at number four, we have Hunter Henry. I've played him as my number one tight end throughout a lot of the year, mainly because of his run blocking and my I formation sets. And then I have a little bit quicker tight end sometimes for other sets, especially out of shotgun. But him being 6'5", he's able to do those things with high point passes towards the goal line. So I'm sometimes subbing him back in for those things. So he is the best run blocking tight end in the game. Sans, someone who came in just a little bit earlier this week. So we'll get into him here in a little bit. But he is going to fit on every team as a second or third tight end till the end of the year. And he should be able to fit as your number one tight end now. I highly recommend him, but I understand there are some other players out there in Madden Ultimate Team that have skill sets that other people do like a little bit better, so they did make it a little bit higher on the list. But I cannot recommend Hunter Henry anymore. Coming in at number three, we have George Kittle. He is the absolute speedster that set the record for the most yards by a tight end in a season. He is a tremendous talent with his speed and being 6'4", 96 spectacular catch, and being capable run blocker. He's someone that can absolutely stretch the field. He was a game breaker when he first came out, and now he is just great at his specific role, which is being a wide receiver at the tight end position. And he splits out a little bit better than Vernon Davis. Vernon Davis is a little bit better on my team because of the Redskins chem, but I do like George Kittle on most teams a little bit better because he has a little bit better speed and run blocking. His strength isn't quite where Vernon's is, but the way that Kittle plays, if you're run blocking, or excuse me, running team, I would highly recommend getting him and then putting him at wide receiver. And if they are starting to load the block, excuse me, load the box, you can throw deep to him and still have the run blocking that's better than any wide receiver. Coming in at number two, we have Franco Harris. He is someone that is a jack of all trades. You can have him as a halfback, fullback, or tight end, and he'll be great at each of those things. I have him as a pass catcher and a pass blocker on my team, but you can have him do quite a bit of different things. If you bump up his running a little bit more, he's able to do that. If you bump up his impact blocking a little bit, he's able to be a perfect lead blocker for you. He is just a tremendous player. Since his lead block is up to that 90 level, he's able to get lead block on him. But if he doesn't have that 90 impact block, sometimes they miss a little bit more at the point of contact, it seems. So just keep that in mind. That's why I have Lorenzo Neal for some of those I formations. But if you run a lot more shotgun, he's able to do a lot of things out of the tight end, out of the backfield, and block better and be quick enough to get away from just about every player. He is the best pass catching person out of the backfield, so keep that in mind as well. He is a tremendous player to have on your team, and since he comes in at fullback, he can play a variety of positions. Number one, we have Rob Gronkowski. I am a little bit disheartened that I was not able to play the last part of House Rules and I was not able to acquire him and a couple of those other great rewards that you were able to get. So I definitely advise going out and doing that. All-time great players not going to be retiring every week, so they're not going to have that type of rewards. But going back into Rob Gronkowski's stats and just who he is on the field, he has the speed of who he was as a young man. I think that Julius Peppers retirement card, just a little bit of a boost there. And before that, he already had the stats in other places that made him one of the best tight ends in the game. Him being a run blocker with that 89 speed just off the bat makes him the best at that. Sadly, he's a little bit better than my Hunter Henry that I've been playing with, but I would go out and do everything that you can get to get this player. Sadly, there's only one on the market right now for 2.3 million. Over time, you're going to be able to go out and get that with training here in about a week. So just keep that in mind. But those players underneath of him are very expensive to power him up. But that's all that we have for the top 10 today. Definitely try to add these players to your team. As I said, a couple of them will be getting upgrades, so their lower players will be a little bit less expensive as this Gronkowski came out, and quite a few players were able to get both of those house rules done. So get your house rules done. Have a great rest of your Sunday, and I wish you all the best. Take care. Thank you for checking into the Irish Orangutan channel. Keep coming back to get better at men and grow your mutt team. There will be at least 5 videos up a week, so make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button to see them all. Come by Twitch to engage and hit me up on Twitter at Irish Orangutan. Take care and much love, everybody.